So hello and welcome to this week's Children's Church at Home. Today is Thursday and it's a very hot day. I think it's going to be the hottest day of the year so far. So I hope that you've been able to enjoy some of the sun this week. I hope that those of you who perhaps been back to school this week will have had a good time and it's been good to be able to see some of your friends. For those of you who are back working, I hope that it's being a good time for you too. This week we're going to think about welcome, and I think it's quite good that our reading from the Bible this week talks about welcome at this particular time, because in a week or so we're going to be able to start to welcome people into our homes. Again, there are very special rules we have to follow to be able to do that, but it will be nice to be able to open our door and say welcome to people. We're going to now have our special prayer for this week. God, our Saviour, look on this wounded world in pity and in power. Hold us fast to your promises of peace, won for us by your Son, our Saviour, Jesus Christ. Amen. So now we're going to have our reading. And I want you to listen out in the reading to see how many times you can hear the word welcome. Or welcomes, or welcomed. Have a listen and see whether you can hear all the different times that's said. Our Bible reading today is from Matthew's Gospel, chapter 10. Jesus said to his followers, "Wherever you go, if people welcome you, then they are welcoming me too. And if they welcome me, then they are also welcoming God." Jesus continued, "If someone welcomes a prophet, that's somebody who speaks God's words, and if someone welcomes them because they are a prophet, then they will receive the same reward as a prophet. If someone welcomes a good person and welcomes them because they are good, then they will receive the same reward as a good person. And if someone helps one of these little ones, if they give them only a cup of cold water because they are one of my followers, then they will certainly be rewarded." So in that story, Jesus was telling his disciples, his friends, to start going out and doing the work that he himself was doing, to go and tell people all about God. And so he was giving them instructions, and he said to them that he wanted them to go out and knock on people's doors, and that if they were welcomed, then they were also going to be welcoming Jesus. Now, I counted the word welcome or welcomed or welcoming 8 times. So it's a really important word. So what Jesus says is, when his disciples knocked on the door of somebody, that person needed to be able to recognize that they were followers of Jesus. Now, that's quite a difficult thing to do. It means we have to be really careful about the things we think and say and do. If we're disciples or followers of Jesus, when people look at us, they need to know we're followers of Jesus, so that they know if they're welcoming us, they're also welcoming Jesus. That means we need to be loving, kind, caring, be filled with hope and compassion. That's thinking about other people. So that's a really important thing for us to do, to be people that when others meet us, they say, "Welcome in, we love being with you." But also, it means we have to think about welcoming. Now, I guess if you've not already met maybe your grandparents or aunts or uncles or mums or dads for some time, when you see them, you'll want to give them a great big hug and say, "I love you," and give them a really warm welcome. We still have to be a bit careful because we can't go hugging everybody, but I'm sure you'll want to be able to give them a warm welcome. And it's quite easy to welcome people that we like, but Jesus is saying we need to welcome people we don't like as well. We can't have one rule for the people we like and another for the people we find it difficult to get on with. So that's the other challenge for us this week, is can we welcome everybody? Can we smile at everybody that we meet? Can we love everybody we meet? Be kind to everybody we meet? That's what Jesus is asking us to think about. To welcome people, as well as making sure that when we are welcomed, that people see something of Jesus in the way we live. So your challenge for the week is be a good welcomer and be somebody that people want to welcome into their house or into their circle of friends. So we're now going to have the Gloria to remind us of God, Father, Son and Holy Spirit, the God who fills our lives with love and hope and joy. So let's have that song of praise, and then we'll have our craft activity. Activity this week, we could do something that would show people that they're welcome when they come to our homes. Now, I don't know whether any of you have got a mat like this at your door that says welcome, so that as soon as people arrive at your house, they can see that you're saying welcome. Well, making a mat might be a bit challenging for us as our craft, but feel free if you know how to make a mat with welcome in it, that would be fantastic. But I thought one thing we could do is make a sign that we put up perhaps either on the door or just inside the door or in a window, so that when people arrive at our house, they know they're welcome. Now, you can do this in all kinds of ways. I made mine actually using the computer because I thought that would make a nice attractive border. And then I've written welcome to our home. You could obviously don't need to use a computer, but you might like to. Or you could just get a piece of paper and decorate it and write welcome to our home. If you want to stick it outside, you might need to do something to protect it. So you might, if you have a laminator, you could laminate it, or you might like to use some sticky back plastic, or you could even kind of use a plastic bag and cover it in it, so that the first thing people see when they arrive at your house is your warm welcome. So that's something for you to perhaps do today. And get ready for more people as they might be able to come and visit you. I'm going to say two prayers. First prayer is a kind of prayer we call a confession. It's a saying sorry to God prayer. Because I think sometimes we don't always welcome people. Sometimes we don't really want to see people. We perhaps don't give them a warm greeting, or we ignore them. And Jesus says, I want you to be welcoming everybody. So let's say this sorry prayer. Lord God, forgive us when we have not welcomed others. Help us and heal our world and welcome all people into your loving arms. Amen. So know that God forgives you. God draws you into his arms of love and gives you forgiveness. Amen. And now another prayer. Heavenly Father, we pray for everybody who feels lonely at this time. For people who feel they've got no friends. For people who've not been able to see anyone for a long time. Help us to be people who welcome. Amen. And now we're going to have our prayer blessing. May God give to you and all those you love his comfort and his peace, his light and his joy, and the blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit be with you now and always. Amen. So, we're more or less at the end of the service. We're going to end with a song that reminds us that Jesus said that we need to be good neighbours to everybody. And that's the same as welcoming everybody. So we're going to sing after I've done the dismissal, When I Needed a Neighbour, Were You There? We're also going to be opening our churches on the 5th of July, not for services yet, but for people who want to come in and say a prayer and maybe light a candle. So during the week, we will be putting out on social media and emails to our congregation and letters, the arrangements for this. Church is going to look a little bit different. We're going to need to keep ourselves spaced apart. We've had to move things that we need to be careful that we don't touch. But we hope that we'll start gradually to be welcoming people back into our church building, to be able to sit, pray, reflect, give thanks to God, pray for those who are ill, maybe remember those who've died. So do look out for that news in the week. But go in peace to love and serve the Lord. In the name of Christ, Amen.